Hi, Dicks. How are you doing?
Service guys. Orders of services. Orders of service. Orders of service guys. Orders of service.
No. Stand up! Hey!
Stand fast, female officers and ratings! Parade! Off! Caps! Great! Stand at ease! Stand easy!
always look on the bright side of life. Time can be a very worrying thing sometimes, can't it? When I look in the mirror every morning and see this old age pensioner staring back at me, I wonder where the last 35 years have gone. When I joined the Navy, the ripe old age of 15, at St. Vincent, just up the road, my expectation was to learn a trade and to travel. Both expectations have been fulfilled, but, and I hesitate to say, as a young and good looking, 35 years ago, no one can remember what I actually looked like. Chief WEA on the Sheffield, after a really good Gulf patrol, with the ship full of Christmas presents, to be told that we were going not home, but were headed down to the other side of the world in a combat situation, well, came as a bit of a shock to say the least. All of us who went, we went not knowing what would happen. And those who came home were, without exception, changed. Life's values had to be re-evaluated. I've now been a priest longer than I was in the Navy, but there is not a day goes by when I do not think about the experience that was and is the Falklands, about the bravery and the brotherhood that we all share, about those who came home and those who were lost, and I still struggle to make sense of it all. People do not realise the mental strain that is present in the lives of those who serve, especially in combat situations. And the world is only just waking up to the fact that our servicemen and women may need help to adjust to life after the services, and especially after warfare. The human race seems to learn very slowly from the mistakes that we make. And warfare is usually a costly mistake, even when it is the only option open to us. So we need to remember, and our children need to remember, so the world will benefit, and so our fight has not been in vain. We can take hope from our reading today, because this church was quite radical in its doctrine when it was written. I hope it still is radical. We are not fighting against flesh and blood, but against the world rulers of this present darkness. Therefore, take the whole armour of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done, to stand. Even in those far-off days when this was written, the cost of warfare was recognised, be it physical or spiritual combat. We are told that the armour of God protects us at the time of the fight and allows us to stand afterwards, bearing the scars that warfare puts upon us. It's a well-known fact that pride is counted a sin. One of the seven deadly sins, in fact. Well, that puts me in a difficult place, because I am very proud to have been a member of Sheffield's crew for the 4 years I spent on board her, especially during the time in the seas around the Falklands. I am proud to be associated with all these people gathered here today to celebrate not the glory of war, but the brotherhood that exists in our armed services, which strengthens us to be able to stand in times of evil and to do the right thing. So march with your heads held high, remembering our own individual journeys through life's rough times. Remembering those at home who were left watching and waiting. And remembering those still on patrol down the south. I am sure that God, in his goodness, will forgive us our pride when we at last come to meet him. Amen.
peace. We thank you that you never leave or forsake us, that in all our need you are with us, to give us courage to stand firm against evil and bring hope to all who are oppressed. We thank you today, especially as we remember with thanksgiving the devotion and self-sacrifice of the men and women in our armed forces. The toil, endurance and suffering of the civilians in the Falkland Islands, and the support of those who sent us help from afar. We remember those who came back, those whose lives still bear the scars of war, those who lost sight or limbs or reason, and those who lost faith in God and hope for humanity. Grant, Lord, that your love may encircle the wounded, the disabled and the mentally distressed, and those whose faith has been shaken by what they have seen and experienced. We remember too the 255 who did not return, who gave their lives in the service of Queen and country. We pray for families bereft and children orphaned. Comfort all who mourn, those that have loved and lost, and all who this day miss the comradeship of friends. Grant that we who serve you may work for your peace and overcome hatred and injustice, so that there may be peace in our homes, our nation, and our world. We ask all these things through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
As Jesus taught us, so we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hooray! Hoof! Hooray! On! Caps! Hooray! Stand at ease! Stand easy.
Steady.
Hooray! Ho!
Oh,
thank you.
During this time, a vow will be laid on the Falklands memorial that each of those who fell during the conflict in 1982. Many of our comrades nouns have passed over since the Falklands War, and they are in our thoughts also at this time.
Carlos R. J. Absalom, M.M. P.O. Engineering and Electrical, M.J. Atos. Air Engineering Mechanic Radio First Class, A.J. Unser. Marine Engineering Mechanic Mechanical First Class, F.O. Arm. Edward Seaman Sonar, D. Armstrong. Corporal R. E. Armstrong. Sergeant J. L. Arthur. Warrant Officer First Class N. Atkinson. Staff Sergeant J. R. E. Taylor. Lieutenant Commander D. R. E. Bradford. Lieutenant Commander R. W. Manfield. Aviation Sonar A. R. Bark. Lieutenant J. A. Barry. Lieutenant Commander G. W. J. Bat, DAC. Corporal W. J. Hayley. Last Corporal G. D. Thank you. Falklands, GPN England. Corporal P.R. Fitton. Chief Petty Officer Writer E. Lappin. Colonel M.W. Fletcher. Admiral E. Foot, M.P. Foot. Marine Engineer Unit, Chemical First Class.
Yeah.
Susan Whiteley.
We will remember them.
Ocorn.
Thank you.
dressing!
Squeeze in, fellas!
Smiling, smiling for the camera!
What do you want?
Well done, it's over.
Middle.